So here's how the power method works. We have our initial vector v, v0. We can write that as x times vector y. What that does is it expresses our vector v in terms of the bases that are formed by the eigenvectors of matrix A. In other words, we can write our vector v as a linear combination of the eigenvectors of A, where the coefficients that we use to take that linear combination are the elements of our vector y. Now, in the first iteration, we take our vector v0, we multiply it times A, which means we multiply this times matrix A, which means that we multiply this times matrix A. Now, let's focus on this right here. What this means is that we can distribute A and write it here. Okay. However, we know that A times x0 is just lambda 0. And this here is just lambda 1. And this is just lambda m minus 1. Okay, so A times v0 leaves you with a different linear combination of the eigenvectors of A, where the coefficients now are the original coefficients, but multiplied by the corresponding eigenvalue of A. Okay. Up here, we can say the exact same thing by recognizing that A times x can be replaced by x times lambda. All right? At that point, we have computed our vector v1. Okay. We go back to the top of the loop. We take v1, we hit it by matrix A to come up with a next vector v2. So we multiply this by A, that means that we multiply this by A, that means we multiply this by A, and by the same argument, A then gets distributed, but that just means that A multiplies x0, x1, etc. And it's not hard to see that the net result of that is that we now square each of these. Okay. Alternatively, you can go up here and say, oh, A times x can be replaced by x times lambda. So this right here is the same as that right there. Okay. This is just a different way of expressing this. At that point, this becomes v2, and we go back to the top of the loop. And if you work it out, you notice that after k such iterations, this holds vk. This lambda is now raised to the kth power, and each individual lambda here is raised to the kth power. All right? Now, notice that we started by saying that the magnitude of lambda 0 is greater than the magnitude of all of these other eigenvalues. What that means is that as k go to infinity, as we keep doing this iteration, this term is going to end up dominating, and all of the other terms are going to be inconsequential by comparison. So how can we make that clearer? Well, we can factor out a lambda 0 to the kth power. And then this right here is just 1. And all of these get divided by lambda 0. And then you end up with quantity to the kth power. And if this is in magnitude greater than that, then you know that raising it to the kth power eventually will wipe that out. And what you're ultimately left with then is that eventually this converges to lambda 0 to the kth power times psi 0 x 0. Now, we only care about the direction. So notice that therefore, eventually its direction ends up being in the direction of the eigenvector associated with the largest eigenvalue. Now, there are a couple of caveats. One is, if we were extremely unlucky and our initial guess had no component in the direction of x0, then we may not end up amplifying in that direction. And therefore, we don't end up pointing in that direction. And it may also be that this coefficient is very, very small and that therefore it takes a very long time to get there for the rest of them to become, relatively speaking, small. Another concern is if our lambda 0 in magnitude is greater than 1, then raising it to the kth power is eventually going to make this vector arbitrarily large. That's probably not a good thing. It probably would lead to overflow. And if lambda 0 in magnitude was less than 1, then eventually lambda 0 to the kth power in magnitude would become arbitrarily small, and therefore eventually our vector would underflow. But in principle, what we have now is a method by which we can find something that points in the right direction.